I was just thinking of something out of thin air. I came out from work and I just thought of WWE schedule, their pay-per-view schedule throughout the year, and I'm just like, we don't really need all of that. We don't really need all this and that, We don't really need a fast lane. We don't need a Hell in a Cell. I mean, it's been documented for the last, like, how many years now? We don't really need these pay-per-views. So I just thought out of discussion, why not we talk? Why not? Instead of just sitting there wondering, why don't we just discuss how you would handle a WWE pay-per-view schedule? Now, for me, I already have seven pay-per-views in mind. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm not gonna do a dream scenario. I'm not gonna do a dream scenario where, oh, you would have Armageddon and you would have Over the Limit, or you capital punishment. No, I'm not doing all that. I'm not doing all of that. What I am gonna do is I'm gonna sit here and tell you with the cards that I'm dealt with here, I'm gonna tell you how I would handle the current WWE pay-per-view schedule.
You what?
So, with their current WWE pay-per-view schedule, what I would do is just trim out the fat. Yeah, right? So, pretty much, Royal Rumble, self-explanatory. Elimination Chamber is self-explanatory. WrestleMania, self-explanatory. What I would do after WrestleMania, first I would do the draft after WrestleMania, but it seems they like to do the draft in October, which is odd to me. I would do it after WrestleMania. And then, by May, early June, you would have Money in the Bank, right? You don't need a backlash. We don't. I'm at the point now where the pay-per-views with stipulations are the ones that are entertaining to me. If NXT didn't do War Games, I don't think I would give a damn about an NXT special event because they're not called takeovers anymore. With WWE pay-per-views, Money in the Bank is the first one after WrestleMania, late May, early June, right? You have the Saudi show to fill in the gap between Money in the Bank and SummerSlam. The SummerSlam is the next pay-per-view. And then you would have Extreme Rules in September. I guess early August, you would have SummerSlam. Early September, you would have Extreme Rules. And then you would have the Saudi show Crown Jewel late October. And then mid to late November, Survivor Series. And that's it. Seven pay-per-views, nine including the Saudi shows. Why? It's self-explanatory, really, if you think about it. We don't need a Hell in a Cell. We don't need a TLC. What we do need is matches, or what we do need is pay-per-views that has entertaining stipulations. Money in the Bank pay-per-view itself has been a historical, well-known pay-per-view in the last decade, right? So we keep that. That'll be the first pay-per-view after WrestleMania. Well, you have the Money in the Bank stipulation. Everybody looks forward to that. Like, ooh, who's gonna win it? Sami Zayn gonna win it? Is this one gonna win it? That one gonna win it? Is she gonna win it? Is she gonna win it? Etc. There's something people talking about. Ain't nobody talking about Hell in the Cell. Ain't nobody talking about Backlash. Ain't nobody talking about TLC. Like, come on. Something to give a damn. That's just me. Money in the Bank says it all. Saudi show happens. Then we get straight to SummerSlam. Bring out the big guns, the Edge, the Cenas, the Brocks, etc. And then Extreme Rules. I mean, do I need to explain? I am going to explain, but do I really need to? No, not really. What you do with Extreme Rules, it's simple. Every single match, and I mean every match, gotta have a stipulation. Gotta. I don't care if it's a tables match. A TLC match, a ladder match, a Extreme Rules, No Holds Barred, Street Fight, False Count Anywhere match, whatever. Iron Man, there's gotta be a stipulation. Something entertaining for people to watch. And what I would do as far as the Hell in the Cell thing goes, I mean, now, naturally, yes, I would bring it out for when a blood feud deserves it. But if that's not the case, and WWE's gonna do it anyway, I would rotate. Once every other year, Hell in a Cell comes out. What would be that gap every other year? Simple steel cage. So the first year, so let's say 2022, you do Hell in a Cell. Have a blood feud end in the Hell in a Cell right there. Then the next year, 2023, steel cage, and then Hell in a Cell 2024, and etc. 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 Every other year, something they change. because I don't see them putting up a steel cage and then doing a Hell in a Cell, some bullshit like I did in my Universe Mode. It's not gonna happen, right? That's what I would do. That's just an idea I have in my head for Extreme Rules, right? The main event could be the Hell in a Cell or the steel cage, or it could be the Extreme Rules or something, right? Something with regarding the Universal or WWE Championship. I am not against a pay-per-view main evented with a number one contenders match in the end. I'm not against that. Why? Because it's something that matters. Ooh, I would love to see my guy versus the guy I don't want to win here. Oh, snap! Like, you know, like, something. There's something there. If the title does not need to be defended, have a contenders match on the pay-per-view. If it has to main event, let it main event. Have the champion and the challenger face-to-face and meet at the Crown Jewel pay-per-view, I guess. I don't know. But that's what I would do for the Extreme Rules. Change it up, okay? Every match got to have a stipulation. And now, the last pay-per-view I'm going to talk about is Survivor Series. This is where I'll change things. I'm going to take what I did with the Universe Mode and apply it in real life. King of the Ring. I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I don't really like tournaments that often. It's funny, it's like when I watch it in real life, I don't really care for tournaments compared to me doing it a lot in Universe Mode when I really have nothing creatively. It's like, oh, why not do a tournament? King of the Ring? I thought of doing King of the Ring, like, its own pay-per-view in my Universe Mode, but I'm like, you know what? Nah. Because I'll be honest with y'all, I'm sick and tired of Raw and SmackDown Survivor Series matches. I'm tired of it. What do you gain from it? At least with the King of the Ring, you could have the Raw and SmackDown guys fight each other, and then in the finals, you have Raw versus SmackDown. Oh my God, who's going to win? Right? You could have the matches, you could have qualifying matches take place on Raw and SmackDown. I mean, that's what they're for, right? You have the qualifying matches happen on Raw and SmackDown separately, and then you have the whole thing. 8 men fight on one night. Done deal. What else do you fill in with that? You fill in the gaps. You can do champion versus champion matches, I guess, or you could have title matches. Literally, that's literally it. Pretty much what I would do. It's simple, right? Do you like it? Is it good? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you guys for watching this video. I just thought of it out of thin air. I'm just looking at the pay-per-view schedule. I'm just like, we don't really need all this. We really don't. You know, after day one, that's when things start to go down the right path. So you would have the Rumble, Elimination Chamber, WrestleMania Night 1 and 2, Money in the Bank, Saudi Show, SummerSlam, then Extreme Rules with every match being a stipulation, with the Steel Cage and the Hell in a Cell rotate each year. And then you would have the Saudi Show Crown Jewel in October, and then Survivor Series with the King of the Ring being the main focus of that show, and then you call it a day. 7 pay-per-views, 9 when you include the Saudi shows. Let me know in the comments below. Thank you guys for watching, and I'm out. Later.